Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14.2 Beta 1 has been out unexpectedly for about a week or so. It was sort of a surprise. iOS 14.2 skipped iOS 14.1. So I want to talk about a major problem with iOS 14.2, talk a little bit about maybe why you should hold off installing it. And also let's talk about the iOS 14.1 release date. Now, the first thing is iOS 14.2 has been okay on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. So it's actually been okay, but it's been terrible in one respect on my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. So the first thing is the overall stability, at least on the iPhone for me, has been okay. I really have not run into many issues, and overall stability and speed seems to be okay. I really haven't had any app crashes. The overall performance has been really good. You'll see scrolling is nice and smooth. Opening music has been fine. No issues there. And you'll see everything just seems to be fairly fast and fluid. And this particular update does fix some issues that are in iOS 14. But this update seems to have a huge issue for some people. And this was an issue for me last night on my iPad Pro. And what I mean is my 12.9 iPad Pro, I was using it without a problem. And then all of a sudden I noticed, hey, my battery's low. So it was draining quickly, but I noticed my battery was not at 94% like it is now, but rather it was at 10%. And then I went to plug it in and I didn't have any charge. There was no indication of a charge. I couldn't charge it at all. So I tried various chargers. I tried a MacBook charger. I tried the iPad Pro charger, and this is the one that comes with it. I also tried third-party chargers, and nothing seemed to work. So I took the cable. This specific one is from a MacBook, but it's the same USB-C cable, and you'll see it's charging now. And that's because I was able to downgrade it. So I was able to downgrade it to iOS 14. In fact, I had no way to charge it except for the Magic Keyboard. Now, what I mean by that is if you have a Magic Keyboard, you'll know that there's a USB-C port built into it. And I was able to charge with that. Now, had I not had an accessory with that that uses the pogo pins to charge through the iPad, I would have had no way to charge my iPad. In fact, I plugged it in, tried multiple cables, tried multiple plugs. Then I plugged in my iPad with the charge cable to the Magic Keyboard and it charged. So I knew that it would accept a charge, but this was a software bug. I thought maybe the port had gone bad and it's under warranty, so that's not too much of an issue other than that the stores near me are closed, so I would have to send it in or something along those lines. But what I found is once I was able to connect it to a computer using a USB-C to Lightning cable, that took a couple tries. I was able to get it to connect to my MacBook. Then I downgraded it using the IPSW file to the official iOS 14 version. As soon as it rebooted, I was able to charge it. Now, the scary thing to me with this is had you not had a Magic Keyboard or a computer to downgrade, the problem is if you drop below 50%, you can't upgrade your iPad to the next version. And so if you actually came out with iOS 14.2 or iPadOS 14.2 beta 2, for example, I wouldn't have been able to update this to the next version unless I had more than 50% charge. So that's a little bit scary, and that's why I would highly caution you against updating to iOS 14.2 right now. Now, with future updates, I'm sure they'll fix this, and Apple seemingly fixes this. And in fact, if you were using iOS 14.2 on an iPhone 11 or XR, they've since pulled that. So it's not available for even the developer or public beta. Initially it was, then the XR and 11 were pulled from it. Now that could have had to do with something with the screen resolution or the charging, but this is why I caution people not to use betas unless they have computers to deal with the problems, at least early on anyway. Later on in the betas, when you get closer to say a letter B or A at the end of the build number, you're usually pretty safe to try it. But early on, I highly caution against it. And so I think Apple released iOS 14.2 so that they had some software to install in the hardware manufactured iPhone 12 and 12 Pro or 12 Pro Max, like this prototype here. So Apple's already started producing them. And in order to produce them and have the correct firmware on them that they want to support all the features in the next iPhone, they needed to have it ready. Maybe that's what iOS 14.2 is for. And so that leads me to iOS 14.1. So I think Apple is going to release iOS 14.1 as soon as tomorrow. Now, I thought it would be today. And the reason I say that is last night, Apple actually stopped signing iOS 13.7. So what that means is once they stop signing an update, it means you can no longer downgrade and you can't go back to iOS 13 anymore. So maybe you have a device that runs iOS 12. You'll be fine with that. You can continue to run iOS 12 if your device doesn't support iOS 13. But for all iOS 13 supported devices, the next time you go to update it or you want to downgrade, it will be an iOS 14 version, not 13.7. So we're done with iOS 13 and looking forward is iOS 14. Now, this is a good thing and a bad thing. Some people really liked iOS 13, and it seems like they really fixed all of the bugs with it, all the crashing and weird things, and a lot of people don't like things like this new weather widget, for example. But in the newest version, I think they're going to fix a lot of issues with iOS 14.1. So I would hope to see either 14.1 or 14.0.1. I would be really surprised if it wasn't 14.1, since they released 13.1 only 5 days after iOS 13. So I think we'll see 14.1 pretty soon as tomorrow. It could be early next week, but hopefully as soon as tomorrow, based on what they've done in the past. The only version you can downgrade to is iOS 14 right now. Normally they leave two. So we've got 14.2 beta, iOS 14, 14.1 should be right around the corner. So expect iOS 14.2 around the launch of maybe iPhone 12 and iOS 14.1 to come to all of your devices as soon as tomorrow. Hopefully we see that. I'd love to see that available with a bunch of bug fixes. iOS 14 definitely still has some issues. And let's quickly talk about battery life on 14.2. If you're already on it, I'd love to hear from you below. My battery health is at 95% after about a year of usage. And over the last 10 days, I've gotten okay usage. So for example, we'll see 2 days ago, I got 4 hours and 54 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 12 minutes of screen off time, and used 75% of my battery. This is not really great usage on this beta. Before that, it seemed to be a little bit better depending on what I was doing. But in general, some people are having phenomenal battery life with iOS 14. Other people are having a terrible experience. It's very much dependent on which apps you use. Now, as far as iOS 14.2 beta 2, I would expect that probably within another week or so. Usually early on in betas, Apple goes on a 2 week schedule, sometimes even three, but more likely seems to be two. So we'll be on a bi-weekly schedule until we get closer to the final release. Now, Apple, of course, could change this at any time, but seeing that we're getting iOS 14.2 and already skipping 14.1, which may not even come out in beta form, probably will be on a 2 week schedule and they'll just have this next week at some point. Now, again, this particular beta in general surprised us at about 6 p.m. Eastern time, at least on the East Coast of the United States. So again, Apple's been doing things very randomly these days and we may or may not see it next week, or maybe we'll see it as soon as tomorrow. Also, they could release both at the same time. Hopefully they don't do that and we can get some more time with the standard version of iOS 14, or maybe who knows what Apple will do at this point. But I definitely think we'll see that final release of iOS 14.1 or 14.0.1, whatever they decide to do, fairly soon. Now, I'll have some battery tips coming up soon, like I do every single year, with iOS 14 and how to save battery according to Apple, and specifically according to Apple, and also a few extra tips that might help as well. That'll be in a future video along with a few others. But for now, stay away from 14.2 if you can. If there's some bugs that are really, really bugging you with 14, it's fine, but try and stay away from 14.2 beta 1 at least. Wait until beta 2 and see if it fixes those issues. That charging issue is pretty major. But let me know if you've had that issue in the comments below. A couple people have sent me messages on Twitter saying that they had issues not only with their iPad, but their iPhones and things. So that's pretty major, I think. So again, I would just hold off, wait for the official release. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, this is from AR7 2014 on Twitter. This is a combination of the light and dark mode wallpapers that come with iOS 14. So I think it's really nice. You can kind of separate it by widgets or create whatever you'd like, but you've kind of got a split personality on your device. I think it's kind of neat. But if you'd like to get your hands on that, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.